Good evening, everyone. Today I will be talking about how to approach red eye. Like, red eye can be either visual threatening or non-visual threatening. So we have to know when to manage and when to refer to an ophthalmologist. Lateral or involving both the eyes, associated with visual loss, pain, photosensitivity, history of trauma, contact lens use history is very important because usually contact lens users are more prone to a corneal ulcer. History of autoimmune disease is important in relation to dry eye. So first we have to look for eyelids, whether any thickening of the margin, congestion of the conjunctiva. Cornea, to know how is the clarity of the cornea. Usually if there is haziness of the cornea, it should be referred. Visual acuity also has to be checked. So first, most common thing when we think of red eye will be conjunctivitis. So conjunctivitis could most commonly either could be viral or bacterial. Usually the duration will be of shorter duration, can be involving single eye or both eyes. So viral conjunctivitis, usually we have watery discharge. There will be history of upper respiratory tract infection and associated with preauricular lymphadenopathy. Whereas in case of bacterial conjunctivitis, the discharge will be of mucopurulent and associated with rusty and crusting of the lid margin. Here as you can see, there will be discharge and crusting of the lid margin. So usually most of the conjunctivitis will be self-lit. So patient has to be educated about the hygiene and hand wash. Same kerchief should not be used within the family members. So hygiene education should be given to the patients. Antibiotic eye drop should be given for a week. Most of the conjunctivitis will subside within a week. So next common thing is acute angle closure glaucoma. Usually the patient will present with an age group of 40 to 50 years, present with severe headache. Sometimes even they can come to the casualty, and we have seen cases that have mistaken to be subarachnoid hemorrhage. Patient underwent CT scan, it was normal, then finally referred to ophthalmologist. So a simple examination would be helpful. Here the cornea will be hazy. There can be visual disturbances. Pupil will be mid-dilated. So, and patient can complain halos around the light. So, you have to immediately manage to the ophthalmologist so that anti-glaucoma medication can be started to reduce the intraocular pressure. Next, other cause of red eye will be anterior uveitis. Usually it is associated with photophobia and diminution of vision. It will be usually a history of autoimmune disease will be there. Main treatment will be steroids. So there will be ciliary flush around the cornea, redness, and there can be posterior silicate. Pupil will be festoon shaped pupil. So, and associated with pursing anterior chamber. Here you can see the pus. So it is called as hypogleon. Next, other parts of red eye will be stye. So stye will be swelling of the lid margin. So it can be acute or chronic. Usually acute will be caused by the blockage of disease or meibomian gland that is also known as spondylolisthesis. Whereas chalazion is blockage due to meibomian gland. Usually it will be a chronic condition. Main modality of treatment will be hot compression and applying antiadiabatic ointment. The size does not reduce within a week. Reference to the ophthalmologist a must for drainage of chalazion and hodulum. Next, common cause of bladder will be blepharitis. That is a chronic inflammation of lip margin. Usually there will be dandruff-like particles around the lip margin. So, inspection of the lid will be helpful in identifying the lesion. So, how to manage this case is, you ask the patient to take a bowl of lukewarm water, add 1 or 2 drops of baby shampoo, then with the help of cotton swab or drops of baby bud, you can ask the patient to clean the lid margin. So, usually it will resolve within a month. Next, other cause will be trauma. It can be ranging from corneal abrasion, which will be diagnosed with the help of fluorescein staining. So the epithelial defect will take greenish color with the fluorescein dye. So if you get a case of corneal epithelial defect, you can patch with eye ointment like antibiotic ointment, and you can refer to ophthalmologist so that can see under slit lamp whether any infection, associated infection will be there. In the globe rupture, there will be discontinuity in the cornea or any sclera, and it will be associated with iris tissues. Next will be subconjunctival hemorrhage. It can be diffuse or localized area of blood under the conjunctiva. So though it looks very scary, usually it will resolve itself within 10 to 14 weeks. It will be usually associated with vigorous coughing, sneezing. There will be history of aspirin usage and patient could be hypertensive. So only if it is associated with blurring of vision, have to refer to ophthalmologist. So red flags to be identified, you know when to refer. So if the vision is affected, if it is associated with painful red eye, then there is absence of sluggish pupillary reaction, corneal involvement, and if there is blurred vision with photophobia, if there is history of trauma, a reference to the ophthalmologist must. So red eyes that must be referred urgently will be acute angle closure glaucoma, if it is associated with hyphema, that is blood in anterior chamber, or hypopure, or if there is any corneal involvement, which can be managed by primary care physician of style chalazion, conjunctivitis, blepharitis, and subconjunctival hemorrhage. With this, I come to the end of the press talk.
Thank you. I request our President Dr. Mani to hand over a certificate of appreciation to